Could you sketch your project a little bit for us?
The Rotterdamse baan will be the new connection between Rotterdam and the center of The Hague. Connection, of course, for cars. It will be a motorway, and it's a very strange project because on one side we're in the middle of the city of The Hague, and on the other side, it's a rural environment, and right here now we are in just on the construction site, where a new road will be constructed just above us.
I can imagine that there are some complexities that you face in a project like this. Are there any you can mention?
Well, complexity is, like I said, on one side we are in the just in the city with all things that can happen there. On the other side, a rural environment where we have also all kind of problems. And of course, we are in the Netherlands, so water is always a complex factor with any project.
And water in what sense?
Well, we here are already below sea level, the point where we are standing now, but also all the little rivers, canals that have been digged here in the former years. We found some canals which are built by the Romans just after Christ, and we had to cross them.
You just indicated that actually the environment of the project is very different. Can you explain how you manage with those differences, so those different environments?
Talking. We have a lot of, you could say, ways to cope with the people which surround us. And of course, they are the experts where it's about the environment. They live here, they work here. We are only here their guests for a couple of years. So we are very anxious to know what's on their mind. It's both inhabitants, but also people concerning about the landscape. This is a very, just here above us, a very old landscape, but also talking about all kind of animals, from very little fishes in the river here to enormous bats.
How do you deal with these differences in terms of management? Do you approach different parts differently?
Yeah, because big organizations, you have to be very official with them. On the other side, we have a very little kind of factories. And of course, the inhabitants, we don't cope them with very big contracts or something like that. It's a way of knowing how to talk to one another.
I understood that sustainability is one of the, sort of main drivers of your project. Can you elaborate a little bit on that?
What our goal is here to build the most sustainable tunnel of, let's say, Europe. And sustainability in sense of noise, when the tunnel is in function, noise, air quality, air pollution, but also about the consumption of energy. Tunnels consume a lot of energy, and we are trying to reduce that kind of energy. So in the end, you will see here all our buildings will be coped with solar panels, for instance. Sustainability is a major goal in our project.
And would it be right to state that by putting sustainability so high in your goals that it in fact increases the complexity of the project?
Yes, of course, because it was one of the factors for the contractor to gain the project. So we have to control them also on these kind of factors. And like I said, it's not only in construction phase, but also when the tunnel is in function, and it'll be in function for 100 years.
And can you also also tell us something about the collaboration between you as a client and the people from the contractor?
Well, we believe in a cooperation very tight. So we are actually on the construction site. We are working here from one and the same building. We have a lot of things in common. We try to talk instead of sending mails to one another. And well, this, which is a bit awkward in this period, where everyone uses the mail. We try to avoid that as much as possible.
Do you have recommendations for your colleague project managers to better deal or cope with complexity?
Treat your project like your relationship or your marriage. If you look at the contract every day, it won't take long and you don't have so much fun.